Amen, amen, amen. Jesus is my rock and my salvation. Amen, amen. I am your worship leader tonight. I'm Pastor Bobby McKenzie from Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church of Albion, Michigan. I hope you can understand me with this mask on if I need to take it off, but I want to be respectful. But I want you to know that as the worship leader, I don't know about you. I didn't drive all the way from Michigan to not to worship. I came to worship him and give him glory. Hey! I just want to make sure that this is the new hope. Missionary Baptist Church, I want to make sure I'm in the right place. We didn't come to play with the thing. We came to give him glory, give him honor, and give him praise. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name. We came to worship him. We came to witness what he's doing. We came to give him honor. We came to lift up holy hands. We came to give him praise, which is the fruit of our lips. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name. I believe that we are ready to worship. And so without further ado, we're not going to belabor the time. Without further ado, I bring back to you the New Hope worship team.
How many of you know that Jesus will? Get up on your feet and get with us.
Yeah. as he turned your midnights into day, I know he will. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And because of that, I know there's nobody like my God. There's nobody greater than him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Your name is above all names.
Above all names. Amen, amen. Jesus certainly will, and mighty are the works of his hand. And we know his hands are doing a mighty work because he has replaced, if you will, or set a pastor and a first family into this community called Evansville, Indiana, right here in the New Hope Missionary Baptist Church. And if you want to see how mighty his hands is, I need you to stand on your feet and receive the entrance of the first family. Certainly give honor to God, and it's so good to see my brother, Pastor-elect Jackson and Sister Ngazi, and now to see the New Hope family. And so we're here to celebrate what God has ordained from the foundations of the world, and that he's aligned to manifest in the earth realm on May the 6th, 2022. Amen, amen, amen. And so we're going to hear Old Testament reading by Minister Carlanda Head. We're going to have our New Testament reading by Pastor Floyd Edwards of Mount Olive Galilee Baptist Church. And then prayer by Pastor Larry Rasko of Nazarene Baptist Church, in that order. Amen. Amen.
Can we stand for the reading of God's word? And please remain standing until after the New Testament scripture has been read. I come to you this evening with a passage of scripture from Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15 from the New Living Translation. And I will give you shepherds after mine own heart, who will guide you with knowledge and understanding. God's word is blessed.
From the book of Ephesians, 4th chapter, verses 11 and 12. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. May God bless those who read here and obey his word.
And God, you said you would never leave us nor forsake us. You said you'd wipe all the tears from our eyes. We want to say thank you for this occasion. We honor and bless your name for these, your people, known locally as the New Hope Missionary Baptist Church family. We thank you for what not only you brought them through, but for what you have brought them to. You've been no shorter than your word. You're able to provide all of our needs. And for that, oh God, we want to say, yes, thank you. We thank you for these people who have prayed together, walked together, sought your face, looked and listened for your voice. Thank you for what they have heard from you and for the decision to respond according to the unction of your spirit. And so thank you for the call, for this appointed time, for this beloved pastor, for his wife, for those precious babies. God, we want to say thank you for this new season, and we commit ourselves to loving him, to loving them. We commit ourselves, knowing that there's a work in this community for him to do. And we're excited about what's going to happen as a result of you using this, your precious vessel. Just as we cried, it's a time of celebration. And we pause and come tonight to give you glory, to give you honor for the doors you've opened, for the ways you've made, for the hearts you're healing, for your joy in the time of sorrow. And we celebrate and we take you at your word, believing that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what you have in store for these your people as they serve in this community to change the world. Bless this beloved pastor who shall proclaim your word and everyone that shall come and present. Pray that everything will be done in a way that would bring you glory and honor. And we ask these things not because we deserve it, but we ask it because you said we could. And we do it in the name of Jesus, the soon coming King, we pray. And all God's people said, amen.
We certainly thank these great preachers for the read word, and thank Pastor Rasko for that prayer. At this time, we want to have our welcome by Dr. Candace Hinton, and then a musical selection by the Mount Zion Baptist Church Music Ministry in that order. Amen. Amen.
Grace and peace be unto you from God our Father and Jesus Christ, his Son. Anybody glad to be in the house of God tonight? It's Friday night, y'all. I remember back in, well, might not even been back in the day, but I do remember on Friday night, this is too early. This is pregame. This is pregame, so I'm just wanting, you know, we got saved, and now we do it a little differently. So I just wonder if there's anybody in the house want to have a praise party in here. Ain't no party like a New Hope party, because the Holy Ghost party don't stop. Can y'all lift up the name of Jesus with me in here tonight? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. My job is to bring greetings and to welcome you into the house of the Lord, New Hope Church. All we can say is thank you. Thank you so much for coming. I see churches represented from all across the city of Evansville. I see St. John's East. Pastor Bailey, it is so good to see you. Hallelujah. So good to see you. I see St. James in the house. Mount Olive in the house, and the Nazarene Church, and Liberty in the house, and Memorial in the house, and I see friends from all walks of life. I see Greater Hope in the house. Greater Hope, we love you. You're family to us. Thank you for coming tonight. We love you. We love you. You're our family, and we're grateful that you've come tonight. And so we love the Lord. And I just can't help but think about part of our theme scripture. And it just says, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. He says, see, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? Can you not imagine it? I am making a way in the wilderness and in the streams in the wasteland. Oh, God knows that around about a year ago, we looked like a wasteland. It looked like a wilderness in here. It looks pretty good in here tonight, but about a year ago, let me tell you, it was a little bit dry. I tell my pastor, I said, Pastor, I believe the Lord set you in the valley of dry bones. But we already living. We already getting strength in our ankles and in our knees and in our hips. You know why? Because he's been preaching a word. He has taken us back to the basics. Simple things like a spiritual checkup. Can y'all hear? He said, can you hear? The spiritual checkup, can you hear the word and can you hear God's voice? And he's teaching us about love, just the basics, y'all. He took us back, he's taking us back to the basics. Very foundational, and we have learned so much to walk into the basics. And so we're thankful to God tonight that God has given us a man of God and a woman of God by his side. We thank God for Pastor Jackson and for Lady and Guzzy Jackson. Can y'all help us thank you? Yes, yes, yes. God has been good to us. He's been so good to us. I said he's been so good to us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So consider yourselves welcome. Don't be a stranger. Mount Zion, wait, hold it. Mount Zion, let me tell y'all something. Pastor first told us that there were going to be 10 or 12 of them coming. And then Sister Kim called Sister Kathy. She said, well, actually, we've got a bus. We got a 54 passenger. We're like, oh. And then the next word we got was, we got 67 cousins and brothers coming down the highway, coming from Kalamazoo, Michigan. And so, Mount Zion, thank you so much for giving us the son of the church. And he's here with us. You have prepared him well. And we are so grateful for you you must love him. And y'all came down here to make sure we love him. And we do. We love him. We love Lady and Guzzy. We love those children already. They're going to be spoiled. Y'all just forget about it because we love church babies. And so we're grateful, Pastor Addis Moore. God bless you. Thank you so much. Thank you for what you poured into him. We're getting it all. He's bringing all the smoke. We're getting it all. We're getting all the smoke. We're getting it all. And so we're just grateful. So once again, thank you so much for coming to the New Hope Church. We love you. Please come back. You're not strangers anymore, especially those, our Evansville family. We're not strangers. Y'all come on back. Worship with us anytime. Come out on Thursday nights. We in here churching on Thursday nights. Y'all need to come in here on Thursday nights and worship with us. I know everybody else's Bible study on Wednesday. Y'all can come on over on Thursday and hang out with us. God bless you. Thank you so much.
Can you stand to your feet this evening? We're getting ready to sing to the Alpha, to the Omega, the beginning and the end. Anybody know who I'm talking about? Do we serve the same God? The great I am, the Holy One, the righteous one.
Have me say, you are Alpha and Omega.
You are Alpha and Omega.
You're the beginning and the end.
You're the beginning and the end.
You're the same yesterday, today, and forever.
You're the same yesterday,
yesterday, today, and forever.
I pray
your name.
I pray
your name.
You are Alpha and Omega.
Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Dr. Hinton, for that great welcome. And Mount Zion, you're still Mount Zion. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Before we have the occasion, we're going to have Dr. Adrian Brooks to come forth from Memorial Baptist Church. Before we do that, I do want to highlight all the preachers in the house. If you are a preacher, pastor, preacher, would you just stand and let us look at you just for a second? Amen. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Look at here. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And just so you guys know, Pastor Ryan Jackson is a part of a great family of preachers. Amen. I didn't say it at the top of the hour, but I'll say it now. Dr. Addis Moore is not only Pastor Ryan's pastor, but he's also my pastor. And we got some more pastors that he has birthed into the ministry. I'm going to ask at this time the sons, if you will, the spiritual sons and natural sons of Pastor Addis Moore, if you guys will stand, if all the preachers that are birthed, pastors and preachers, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. This is Dr. Moore's fruit, and Pastor Ron Jackson is a part of his fruit, and I'm going to ask them to stand one more time because I need to separate them from everybody else. My pastoring brothers, Pastor Timothy Troxler from Macedonia Battle Creek, Michigan, and Pastor Jerry Wilkerson from Friendship Baptist Church, Kalamazoo. And then once again, I'm yours truly, Pastor Bobby McKenzie from Macedonia, Albion, Michigan. And we came all the way down because of what God is doing in this place, in New Hope Baptist Church down here in Evansville, Indiana. Lord have mercy. I don't know how they got here. I drove through the rain. I drove through all kinds of bad weather, tired, sleepy. But because of what God is doing in this place, it was worth every mile. I got time to get some sleep later on, but I had to be here to witness what God is doing in the life of my brother and to witness again what he has done in the life of my daddy. Lord have mercy. And so we're thankful. We're thankful to be here. And so as far as the program goes, A statement of occasion. We're going to ask Pastor Adrian Brooks if you'll come forth from Memorial Baptist Church. And then, believe it or not, we're going to hear early in the program from our pastor-elect, Pastor Ryan Jackson, because he's going to introduce the preacher. This ain't no speaker. Now, we got a preacher in the house tonight. And I know that there is a word from the Lord. So let's hear from Pastor Adrian Brooks, and then we'll hear from our pastor-elect, Pastor Ryan Jackson of the New Hope Baptist Church.
Thank you, Lord.
To Pastor Ryan F. Jackson and Sister Jackson, and to all of you, our guest speaker, preacher, who will install his son, and to all of you, my father's children, it is good to be here. We've come to This is a part of the Baptist Church tradition. We would install the new pastor, encourage him, give him his charge, lay a word on him. And because I am in this, I'm your neighbor, And we've already been to Bob Evans and had a great, great, great fellowship. And I promised Sister Jackson that we'd make sure that she got tied up with Sister Brooks and she can show you all the shopping spots. But we've come tonight to celebrate what God has done. Amen. God in his infinite wisdom has blessed our community with, I think, Pastor Jackson, if my memory serves me correctly, you are the same age I was when I became pastor at Memorial. And I had served in Henderson for 10 years, but I came over here and I've been over here for 29 now. And so I'm telling my age, but that's about as far as we're going to go with that one. But it is our hope and prayer that tonight will simply be a launching pad for you to do great ministry in our city. We need you. We need your energy, your creativity, your innovation, your mind. We need you. You know, there's nothing sparks up old blood like new blood. So we are excited to have you in our city. And so tonight we are here to celebrate and thank God for what he has done in the placement of, by placing Pastor and Sister Jackson here in ministry at the New Hope Church. Eyes have not seen nor ears heard what good things God's gonna do. Now, there was a time when Pastor Rasko and I, we were young preachers, and when I came over, we said, he's on Walnut down the street from me, as you well know. And I said, now, Pastor, let's get busy and make our cars meet on Walnut. We did that for a while. Pastor Jackson, you on Brown Way. It runs into Lincoln, curves over to Garvin there and runs up the side of our church there. You get to Holland and preaching over here. Let those cars meet again. We're very excited. Excited to have you and your wife in our community and your children. And so if you just want to hang out with some old folk, come on over to Aiken Park. We'll be over there on the porch. And if it's hot, we'll have lemonade for you. God bless you all. Let's celebrate what God has done at the New Hope Church. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I stand before you all to introduce the preacher for this evening. I count it a distinct honor and privilege to introduce him. 1 Corinthians chapter number 4, verse 15 indicates the Apostle Paul, he is writing to the church at Corinth. And he says, for even if you had 10,000 others to teach you about Christ, you only have one spiritual father. And he said, I became your father in Christ when I preached the good news to you. And over 13 years ago, what captivated me about Pastor Dr. Addis Moore, he was preaching the good news. And 13 years ago, he became my father in Christ. Amen. And for the last 13 years, Pastor Moore has been the leading catalyst in my spiritual growth and development. What I love about Pastor Moore is that he majors in Scripture. He wakes up talking about Scripture. He inserts Scripture into his conversation. He uses every opportunity to talk about the Word of God. Amen. And what excites me about Pastor Moore is he continues to hold true to his purpose. He has thoroughly equipped me and prepared me for the work of ministry. I'm grateful to God for Pastor Moore because he helped mold the man you see today. I thank God for Pastor Moore because he has brought out the best in me. I thank God for Pastor Moore helping to unearth and unlock every gift and every calling that God has placed within the inside of me. I'm grateful to Pastor Moore because he gave me a platform to execute my gift. And I realize and know and understand through the power of God, without Pastor Moore, I'm not here today. I'm here at New Hope because of his training, because of his tutelage, because of his insight, because of his advice. And now I present to you, after you hear selections from Mount Zion, I'm excited and elated to present to you my spiritual father. He got preaching pants on. He got a preaching jacket on. He got a preaching tie on. He got preaching shoes on. He got a preaching crowd with him. And he getting ready to preach. And so after Mount Zion comes in their own way, I present to you the spiritual leader, the shepherd, the chieftain of my home church, Mount Zion Baptist Church. I present to you my pastor, Pastor Dr. Addis Moore.
Come on, can you help me say, you know my name.
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 Oh, how you walk with me, say.
Oh, how you walk with me.
Oh, how you talk with me.
Oh, how you talk with me.
And oh, how you tell me, yeah.
Oh, how you tell me.
That I am your own.
I am your own.
Come on, can we sing that again? Oh, how you walk with me, yeah.
Oh, how you walk with me.
It's such a sweet communion. Oh, how
oh,
you
talk. How you talk with me.
And oh, how you tell me, yeah.
Oh, how you tell me.
Come on, say that. I am your own.
I am your own.
Can we take that to the top one more time? Come on, tell them, say, you know my name.
You know my name.
Come on, we already said it. Though I walk through the valleys of the shadow of death,
you know my name.
I will fear no evil. Why? Because I know that the Lord is with me. His rod and his staff comforts
you
me.
Know my name.
Come on, has he prepared a table for any of you in the presence of your enemies? Come on, say, you know my name.
You know my name.
Yeah, we're talking about the risen Savior. Oh, how you walk with me.
Oh, how you walk with me.
Oh, how you talk with me, yeah.
Oh, how you talk with me.
Oh, in his presence there is liberty. Come on.
Oh, how you tell me.
We don't have to worry when we dwell in his secret place. Come on, that I am.
I am.
That's why I don't have to fear, because you're with me. Oh, how
you talk with me.
No matter what the circumstance looks like, oh, how you tell me. You're holding me up with the righteous right hand. Come on, say that. I am your own.
I am
your own. Come on, right now, just for a few seconds, can you say something to the Lord this evening? You are great, God. You are holy. You are righteous. You are the lover of my soul. You are the great I am. God, we bless you this evening, for there is none like you. You are a wheel in the middle of a wheel. When I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, thank you for being with me. You are my healer, my rod, my staff. Hallelujah. I dare you to declare this with me tonight. Hey, that no fire can turn me, no battle can turn me, no mountain can stop me. Why? Because
you hold my hand.
Yeah, and I'm walking in your victory, cause your power is inside of me. No child can defeat me. Why? Because
you,
come on,
hold,
tell them why. That's why we can declare those things. It's because you know my name. Come on, without a shadow of a doubt, you can declare that you have victory this evening.
You know my name.
Oh, somebody's glad about that thing. Come on, say, you know my name.
You know my name.
Come on, let's take it out. Oh, how you walk with me.
Oh, how you.
Yes, we're talking about the all-powerful, mighty Savior. Oh, how you talk.
Oh, how you talk with me.
And oh, how you tell me.
Oh, how you tell me.
This is the good part right here, that I am your own. Come on, declare that thing. And right now, I will minister you to this evening. And I'm going to say that no fire can burn you, no battle can turn you, no mountain is gonna stop you. Why? Because
you hold my hand.
I can declare that I'm walking in your victory, cause your power is inside of me. No giant can defeat me. Why? Because
you hold my hand.
That's why. No fire. No battle can turn you. No mountain can stop you. Why? Because come on, you declare that. Hey, and I'm walking in your victory, because your power is on the inside of me. No giant can defeat me. Why? Because come on, one more time. That's why. No fire can burn me. No battle can turn me. No mountain can stop me. Why? Because
you hold my hand.
That's why I am walking in your victory. Cause your power is inside of me. No giant can defeat me. Why? Because
you hold.
sing that with us. Come on, just say, you know my name.
You know my name.
Come on, if you're thankful, just lift your hands. Come on, say, Lord, you know my name.
You know my name.
And oh, how you walk with me.
Oh, how you walk with me.
Yeah. It's such a sweet communion. Oh, how you,
talk with me.
Come on, tell them, say, oh, how you tell me.
Oh, how you tell me.
And I am your own.
I am your own.
And the song says this, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, from the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul.
Yes, Lord.
Come on, will your answer be yes? Completely. Yes, my soul. My soul.
Says yes.
Come on, all over the building. Can you sing yes, Lord?
Yes, Lord.
Come on, sing that again. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
From the bottom,
from the bottom of my heart
to the depths of my soul.
Yes, Lord.
I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, from the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul,
I love you.
Come on, say, I really. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Say yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
From the bottom of,
my heart to the depths of my soul. Yes, Lord. Completely. My soul says yes. My soul says yes.
Oh,
my soul says yes.
Without a shadow of a doubt, I will say yes.
My soul says yes.
Not my will, but the will of the one that sent me.
My
soul says yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
My soul
says yes.
again. You may be seated. Amen. God is good. And he is worthy to be praised. He deserves all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. And the record is that the redeemed of the Lord just ought to say so. You ought not let me say that by myself. If the record is the redeemed of the Lord just ought to say so. The record is the redeemed of the Lord just ought to say so. Y'all must didn't hear me. The record is that the redeemed of the Lord just ought to say so. Anybody been redeemed? Why don't you look at your neighbor and say, I've been redeemed. I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. You may be seated. Can I just take a moment? I really want to take all this in because there is no more of a precious moment to see one obey God, discover their purpose, walk in it, and is deployed to now do kingdom business. I don't know about you, but that's a big deal. In a time where we got so many play Christians, there are so many problems that still remain because the person God ordained for them to solve them have not obeyed God long enough to solve the problem in the earth realm that God created them to be. In a time when folk are not serious, in serious times, about doing what God says, when there's one that does that, we ought to celebrate. And so we come to celebrate what God has already done. And so we give praise to Jesus, who is the Christ, the Son of the living God. God is good. Now, you ought not let me say that by myself. I see I'm going to have a couple of problems here tonight. Say, God is good. Amen. 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 Praise God. Let me say this, and I'm going to preach because I got a message to preach, but let me say this. New Hope, now, if you fooling us, we need you to keep on fooling us because we got hospitality on the phone in Kalamazoo from New Hope. And we've been talking to folk, and they were hospitalitizing us before we even got here. Man, we drove up to the hotel that Reverend Chalk, so they were out in the hotel parking lot. They were parking the cars. They got luggage racks, and escorted us into the lobby. Man, you know what? We almost thought we were somebody. I'm like,
I'm like, this us? Man, look, can I tell you? Pastor Jackson, can I tell you? I thank God for New Hope. I thank God for you. I thank God for what we are seeing you are doing. And because you do know 80% of what retain a person in the church is hospitality. Folk don't like unfriendly churches. Folk don't like unfriendly folk. And if you be a Christian, you ought to be hospitable. You ever just seen folk that are Christians and they don't never smile? I'm checking 3 or 4 folk out here now. You got on a mask, but I can see your eyes. You know, if God woke you up, you just ought to smile. I mean, and somebody wrote a song, you just look better when you smile. Look, I'm happy. I'm happy, Pastor Jackson. You and your wife, man, y'all look so good. Man, she got on a little hat. She got a little hat, man, it's cocked to the side. And, man, Jackson, your mama here, man, boy, you grinning and skinning. Oh, praise God. Amen. Look, I told you, I just had to take it in. Let's see. Oh, yeah, my wife said that, you know, she couldn't be here tonight. She's having a few issues, and plus she's dealing with quite a few things, so she could not make it. And so we want to share with her that she is here via live stream, so we thank God for her visiting. And so she just could not take the ride, but we thank God that she is still here through me. Amen. Look, all the pastors, all the preachers, thank you so very much. This is a preacher's thing. It's just good to see what preachers from the city and preachers from anywhere show up when a preacher's installed. There's so much jealousy among preachers. And we all in the same business. And it's good to see preachers that, you know, act like we know God too. So we praise God for all the preach brethren, particularly those that are in this city, that would come to share in this occasion. Here it is. I thank God for Pastor Ryan Jackson getting ready to preach. Let's see. Can y'all hear me? Can I hear me? Because I got at least one holler in me. And when it comes time for my holler, I want to be able to get the holler out. I got one, Jackson. I just got one now. I got one. I don't have a holler. Look, Joshua. Chapter 1. Joshua chapter 1. Stand with me, if you will. Joshua chapter 1. Help me thank God for the Mount Zion church family that have come. All those that have come. Our music ministry, under the direction of our band, Brother Sheldon Turner, and our director of Furman Arts, Sister Shantree Stokes. Amen. And all those that drove and all those that made it possible to be here. Joshua chapter 1. I'm going to start reading the Joshua number 1. Listen to the word of God. New King James Version of the Bible. You will follow me and find these words. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise, go over this Jordan, you and this people, the land which I'm giving them, the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I've given to you, as I said to Moses. Amen to that. Verse number 5, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I'll not leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide an inheritance, the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. Only be strong and very courageous. that you may observe to do according to all the law which my servant Moses commanded you. Do not turn from the right hand or the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to what is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, then you will have good success. The word of God. Thought I want to preach Reverend Jackson. Thought I want to preach New Hope. I thought I want to preach Awaiting Congregation. I thought I want to talk about tonight. I'm looking at this text. I'm looking at New Hope in its more than 150-year history. I think it's 152 now, how God has blessed you over the years. I'm looking at what has occurred and look what is occurred. And I thought I'd talk about, and particularly I heard Dr. Hinton talking about the last year or so when you were in search for a pastor, when you were trying to make sure that you were hearing the voice of God. So I'm looking at all of that and looking at Pastor Jackson that God has delivered here. I thought I'd want to talk about when God is ready to move. I thought I want to talk about when God is ready to move. Help me, if you will, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, old neighbor. Preacher's going to preach when God is ready to move. You do know preaching is God's business, and you do know God majors in leadership, and God is particular about leaders. God uses leaders when he's going to do anything substantial in the earth realm. God prepares someone to lead. You do know the heavens belong to God, but the earth belongs to the children of men. You do know that God has given man charge of this earth. And if God's going to do anything substantial in this earth realm, he does it through an obedient man. And so when God is ready to move, he does some stuff. And I'm looking at the character of Moses. I'm looking at the character, Reverend Jackson, of Joshua. And I see some similarities to what God is doing here. And I want to list 3-4 things, and I want to talk about those things. And then we want to move on with our celebration for today. But when God is ready to move, the first thing that I see in this text, that God commissions his man. That he commissioned his man. Now, commission is that God, he calls to duty someone. He charges someone really to actually take a special position. He actually wants somebody now to complete a specific function. So when God gets ready to move, when he gets ready to make something happen, he commissions his man. Okay, Reverend, where do you see that? Well, I see it in verse 1 and 2, because the text said, after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua. Now, I see something there because, watch this, and because I really want to show the analogy that's going on, and because at this time Israel was stagnant because they didn't have a leader. They weren't going anywhere. They weren't doing anything because they didn't have a leader. But when God got ready for Israel to move, he commissioned a leader. New Hope didn't have a leader. You really weren't going anywhere. You heard Dr. Hinton say it didn't look too good in here a year or so ago, but God was already doing some things. He commissioned a leader, and the first thing he does when he commissions a leader, he gets somebody that has already been prepared by God. Can I tell you, when God spoke to Joshua, he had already been preparing Joshua. you remember in Numbers chapter 28, you remember when Reverend Troxel, when God was telling Moses, say, I'm going to show you the promised land, but you ain't going. And Moses have this dialogue with God, and Moses wants to talk to God, and he said, God, now, chapter 27, ready? Really? He says, now, can you really let me know, can you pick out a man? And so I'm looking at this text, and in verse number 18, it said, the Lord said to Moses, take Joshua, the son of Nun, with you, a man with whom the Spirit is in, and lay your hands in. So this ain't the first time that God was looking at Joshua. He had prepared him while he was with Moses. I'm trying to preach just a little bit. Well, make it fit, Reverend. Well, Reverend Jackson been with me. And let me read you a little bit more for it. And he said, and verse 20, he said, and give some of your authority to him, that all the congregation of the children of Israel may be obedient to him. He had prepared Joshua because Moses had given him, Joshua, some leadership positions while he was with him. So folk, before he got into the helm of leading Israel, Joshua already had folk that was obedient to him. I'm trying to preach an installation message here because Reverend Ryan F. Jackson, he was at the Mount Zion Church, and he was director of discipleship. And he was in charge of just about 400 folk that's in fulfillment hour and our Sunday school. 6 of 5 and 7 of the teachers that reported to him, he'd been prepared. So when God is thinking about New Hope, he looked and got a prepared person. If you can buy an amen, can you just say it right there? If you don't have an amen, ask your neighbor, can I borrow one of yours? Come on, look at him and say, I see you ain't saying nothing. You ain't using your amen. Let me have yours. Before I start preaching today, I talked to Reverend Trox. Reverend Trox said, Pastor, when you get up and say, y'all ain't hearing me, he said, now we really can't hear you, but I think they got the mics ready now. Can y'all hear me? So he commissioned a man. He commissioned somebody that's prepared. Say amen right there. That's pre-approved. Not only prepared, but he's pre-approved. And see, New Hope, you voted. And what you did was what God had already did. So you got somebody that was already pre-approved. You thought you was approving him, but God had already pre-approved. So when you vote, you had to vote the way you did it because God had already approved it. Pre-approved. I've been pastor a while, and y'all been churching a while, and y'all know whenever you get a new pastor, even though he's been pre-approved, some 3 or 4 of y'all still don't like him. But he's still pre-approved. I wish I had a witness in the house. It's 3 or 4 folk don't like what's going on. It's 3 or 4 folk y'all ain't happy, but he's still pre-approved. Why don't you look at somebody and say, the devil is a liar? No, you got to say it right now. Stretch your shoulders back and say, the devil is a liar. I'm trying to quit. Charter, he commissions a man that's prepared and pre-approved. Now, after... Sean, after he commissions a man that's prepared and pre-approved, the next thing he do, because I'm almost done, next thing he does, then he covers his man. I'm going to read it to you in the text. Can I read it to you? Then he covers his man. And I like this. I couldn't wait to preach this part here. I'm like, God, let me hurry up and preach this.
That's why I hurry up and preach number one, because I wanted to get number two. Because this gets the folk that, you know, the folk that don't like it. God going to use you to show how good he is. And so, see, God needs some folk that ain't going to act right, that don't like things and going to cause trouble, so he can show ain't nobody better than God. He needs some enemies because he needs to prove that the enemy can be your footstool. He needs somebody ain't acting right because he need to prove that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord, the call according to them purpose. So that's what, y'all that don't feel good and don't act right, do your thing, baby, because God got something in store. Now, I caught the eye of three or four folk. I saw you. I caught the eye of three or four, like, He covers his man. Can I read the covering? I told you I'm in verse 5. He said, Jackson, now this is what God's saying to you. I'm talking about Joshua, but I'm preaching to you. He said, Can I read number 5? Are y'all looking at number 5? Tell your neighbor, number 5. He covers his man with a promise, because this is what he said. He said, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. Are you kidding? What a promise. How would you act if you knew that the stuff you were going to do sure enough was going to work because God promised it? How would you behave if you believe God enough and he told you, I'm sending you on assignment to New Hope, Evansville, Indiana. And Jackson, when you get there, don't care what they do, what they try, no man will be able to stand before you all the day. He covers him. I mean, he spreads his protection over him. That means God is in charge. How do you, and that's what I love about preaching and ministry, because God gives you a lifestyle, lifetime guarantee. I've been pastoring long enough to know if you stay with God, it's sure enough going to work. Come hell or high water, it's sure enough going to work. I've seen Isaiah 54:17. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every lying tongue shall be condemned. I've seen, yeah. Romans 8:31. If God be for you, nobody can be against you. I've seen Romans 8:28. All things work together for good of them that love the Lord, for those that are called according to his purpose. I've seen. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. I've seen him. Isaiah 40:31. Somebody help me shout. If you wait on him, he'll renew your strength. And you'll be able to mount up with wings as eagles. Run and not be weary. Walk and not faint. I ought to have three or four folk saying hallelujah there. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death? I fear no evil. He'll cover you. He'll cover you. He'll cover you with a promise. When God calls you, and when he get ready to move, he commissions you. He covers you with a promise. Not only covers you with a promise. Now this one, y'all ain't gonna be able to stand this one. You ain't gonna be able to stand it. Look at your neighbor and say, you ain't gonna be able to stand it. I'm gonna read it and you're gonna say, I can't stand it. I already know what you're gonna say. You ain't gonna be able to stand it. Because I read it before I got here. And when I read it, I'm like, I can't stand that. And so I said, when I preach that, now dang, I'll be able to stand it. Here's the next one. I'm trying to tell you. I like you. What's your name? She's so happy. She must be related to Dr. Hinton. So here it is. He also covers him with his presence. You can't stand it. Because the text says, as I was with Moses, I will be with you. I'll not leave you and not forsake you. That meant something to Joshua. Joshua was with Moses at the Red Sea. Joshua was with Moses when he stretched out the rod and the water parted. Wait a minute. As I was with Moses? Joshua was with Moses when he took the rod and threw it down and it turned into a snake. Joshua was with Moses when I came out of Egypt. Joshua was with Moses when they went up to get the laws. As I was with Moses. Joshua was with Moses when the people rebelled against him and said, God, talk to us. And then God opened up the earth and swallowed folk. Joshua with Moses. Wait a minute. As I was with Moses, I'll be with you. I'll never leave you. I wouldn't pastor without God. I wouldn't preach without God. And that's the presence. God is here. So when you see Jackson standing up here with his little skinny self, when you see Jackson, when he's closing, he closes to his left. He don't close all the way. What you say? Y'all knew Hope, y'all know it. He get in the highway, he closed to his left. That ain't just him. God is with him. I'm closing. I'm done, Jack. I'm tired, man. I'm done. When God is ready to move, number one, when I pause, it's your turn. I use the check and see if people listen. Number one, when God gets ready to move, number two, when God gets ready to move, finally. My brothers and sisters, when God gets ready to move, he commands his man. Because he sent him to do this impossible assignment. And what I love about God is, whenever he commissions a man, it's not about the man. It's about trying to get the other folk to their destination. Joshua, you got a job to do. Jackson, you got a job to do. Joshua, there's some folk that didn't get what I promised yet. And I need you to lead them to the blessing. Jackson, New Hope is 152 years now. There's some folk that still didn't get the blessing. There's some folk that still don't know the word of God. Folk that still haven't learned to obey God. And I promised them life in it more abundantly. So Jackson, your appointment here is not just about you. You've got to equip the saints for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. You've got to tell folk to follow me as I follow Christ. You've got to feed the flock with knowledge and understanding. You've got to take heed to yourself and the flock that the Lord has made you overseer. So then God commands you And first of all, I love this. Because whatever, every command God gives us, it's packaged with divine enablements. So whenever God commands you, and this is what folk don't realize, when God gives you a command, all the strength of God is in that command. All the provisions of God is in that command. And Jackson, he said it to Joshua, and I'm going to say it to you. As you matriculate here at the New Hope Church in Evansville, Indiana, first thing God, is to be strong. When I read the text, he said, now he's already given you assignment, but he says, be strong. And whatever God tells you to be strong, and notice he didn't say, go try and work on strong. He said, be strong. That means I already put strong in you. And what you got to do is do who you are. Be strong. And if you ever read your Bible, you know you can't be strong without God. Zechariah tells us, not by power, not by might, but my spirit, says the Lord. Jackson, you're going to need the spirit of God. Have I right about it? My brothers and my sisters, be strong in the power of God. Philippians 2 and 13 says, not in your own strength, but it's God in you, energizing in you. Jackson, it's going to be some long days. But be strong. Can y'all help me close? Say, be strong. Look at him and say, Pastor, be strong. And you can be strong in the power of God. Because when you lean on God, you can make it anyway. Have I got a witness? And not only that, he said, be courageous. I said, be courageous. God didn't give you the spirit of fear, but he gave you power, love, and a sound mind. And what I love about this text, he didn't tell him to be strong and courageous because he wanted him to fight people. He said, be strong because some folk are depending on you to reach their destiny. Be strong because you got a divine inheritance of the land which I swore to your fathers. Be strong. There's somebody got a business in them. Be strong. Somebody got a ministry in them. Be strong. Somebody got an anointing that needs to be released. Be strong. Somebody is bondage that needs to be released. Be strong and courageous enough. And I preach long enough that you got to be able to say it just like God tell it to you. Have I got a witness? And if you be strong and if you are courageous, then he said, be successful. Oh, yeah. God didn't send you here to fail. You weren't trained to fail. You didn't go through what you go through to fail. Can I get a witness? God sent you and your wife and girls here to be successful and what God said. And somebody going to tell you later on, but I love verse 8. He said, I'm going to make sure that you're successful. I'm going to give you a book. And he said, this book of the law. And so every time somebody says something to you, you say, I got a book. Every time they get on your nerve, you say, I got a book. Can I get a witness? Every time you don't know what to do, I got a book. It said, this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, and you should meditate on it day and night, that you may observe to do all that's within it, and then you will have success. Because Jackson, in the book is everything you ought to preach. In the book is every to write, every lesson you ought to teach, in the book, it's already laid out. And when you get in the book, you're going to be like Jesus. Because I remember Jesus, when he first stepped off into ministry, y'all know what he did, right? He went in the temple and he opened up the book and he found himself in the book. And Jackson, find yourself in the book. And in the book, he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And he's anointed me to preach the gospel of the poor. I've got the clothes now. And what Jesus did, he ordered his life according to the book. What he did was in the book. He behaved like the book told him to behave. He said what the book told him to say. I feel pretty good here. Are y'all hearing me? And when he went to Calvary, the Bible declares that he was born according to the scriptures. He lived according to the scriptures. He died according to the scripture. And he was raised according to the scripture. What are you saying, Reverend? You came here according to the scripture. Stay here according to the scripture. Preach according to the scripture. Tell everybody that he died one Friday, but early Sunday morning. Wait a minute. I gotta get my holler. Oh, yeah! I think I got two. Oh, yeah! He got up! He got up! He got up with all power in his hand. Help me shout hallelujah. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Say, neighbor! God is ready to move. He's commissioned a man. He covers a man. He commands a man. Say yeah.
Hallelujah. Come on, if you're able to stand, come on, stand with us if you're able. Come on, let's thank God for the word of God. Let's thank God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So why does God do all of this? Pastor Moore told us in his message, because folks have not gotten everything that God wants them to have yet. The reason he sends a leader is so that individuals can get all that God wants you to have. Meaning that I can't get all that God wants me to have without being under that leader, under leadership. First of all, there's submission to Christ. The scripture says if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. And if you're here tonight and you've never surrendered, you're not surrendered to Jesus Christ, he's not Lord. What does that mean? That he's my boss. He tells me what to do and I will do it. If I believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead, you'll be saved. If you're here tonight, we invite you to come and surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. There's no Christ, there's no God like our God. So we invite you to a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. And secondly, for those of you who say that Jesus is Lord and he's telling you this is where you need to be, now you need to come and you need to connect so that you can get all that God wants you to have. I love you, Jesus. Come on, y'all know it. Say, I worship.
I worship and adore you.
Come on, you got time to come.
Just want to tell you.
What do you want to tell him?
Lord, I love you
more than anything.
More than
you got time. If you're here in this space, come on,
Now's a great time to respond. I love you, Jesus. There's a man that's been commissioned by God and covered by God and commanded for your benefit. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you. If you lift the Lord Jesus Christ up, he said, I will draw all men. Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Yeah. Say, I worship. Just want to tell you. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More than anything. Come on, you still got time to respond. Come on, lift the name of Jesus. Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
You got time to come.
I worship and adore you.
Oh, just wanna. What do you want to tell them?
Lord, I love you more than anything.
You may have your seats. Why don't we just give God a hand clap of praise for the word that has come forth tonight. Amen. Dr. Moore, thank you. Thank you for that word. Amen, amen. So that we don't belabor the time, we want to go into the act of installation. And so we ask that you hang with us, be patient with us, that we take care of this very important business of installing a pastor. And so I'm going to ask my brother, Pastor Jerry Wilkerson, pastor of the Friendship Baptist Church, if he'll come forth and give the charge to the church, followed by my brother, Pastor Timothy Troxler from Macedonia Baptist Church of Battle Creek. He will give the charge to the pastor, and followed directly by behind Pastor Troxler is his bride, Sister First Lady Nicole Troxler from Macedonia Battle Creek, and then followed by Pastor Dr. Reverend Christopher Moore, Assistant Pastor of Mount Zion, and he will bring forth the presentation of the Word of God. And then the installation prayer. We're just going to flow right with the program. Amen. In that order, Pastor Wilkerson.
Check my. Good evening. My assignment to charge New Hope Missionary Baptist Church. I charge you to have the right relationship with the Savior. I charge you to have the right relationship with the Spirit of God. I charge you to have the right relationship with your shepherd. I charge you, New Hope, to have the right relationship with each other, the saints. I charge you to have the right relationship when you come into the sanctuary. I charge you to walk by faith and not by sight. I charge you to act on faith and not act on your feelings. I charge you, based on your decision that you act on the word of God and not on your emotions. I charge you to present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. I charge you to cooperate even when you cannot operate. I charge you to work out your own soul salvation, that with fear and trembling. I charge you not to grieve the Holy Spirit when the word of God is going forth. I charge you to help Pastor Jackson to open up the eyes of the people as he preaches the gospel. I charge you to help your pastor so that people will turn from darkness to light. I charge you to help Pastor Jackson to let the people know that they can receive forgiveness for their sins. I charge you to help Pastor Jackson offer the people an inheritance among them which are sanctified through the faith. I charge you to stir up the gifts that is within you here at New Hope Baptist Church. I charge you to walk worthy of the vocation wherein you are called. I charge you to press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. I charge you to always look to Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of your faith. I charge you to strengthen your spiritual muscles with the word of God. I charge you to be sharp and use the word of God as it's intended, as a two-edged sword. I charge you to gird your loins for this race. I charge you to enhance your vision with the future that is going to be preached through the word of God. I charge you to equip your hands for the work. I charge you to work and not whine. I charge you to heal and not hurt. I charge you to cleanse and not complain. I charge you to assure and not accuse. I charge you to help your brother and not hinder your brother. I charge you to be a blessing and not a burden. I charge you to give respect and not ridicule. I charge you to give and not gripe. I charge you to tithe and not tip. I charge you to make New Hope better, not bitter. I charge you to make New Hope stronger and not weaker. New Hope, I'm charging you this evening. I'm charging you to be mature and not childish. I'm charging you to be fruitful and not barren. I'm charging you to make New Hope richer and not poor. I charge you to magnify God. I charge you to appreciate God. I charge you to sanctify God. I charge you to glorify God. I charge you to obey God. New Hope, you have been charged.
Dr. Moore, once again, our pastor has made my job much easier on tonight as he stopped and parked in verse 8 and he talked about the book of the law. So Pastor Jackson, pastor of the New Hope Baptist Church in Evansville, Indiana, I charge you to take your stand upon the scriptures, upon the Bible, upon the book of the law. I charge you to teach it. I charge you to study it. I charge you to absorb it. I charge you to love it. I charge you to live it. Teach it to transform, instruct it to inspire, feed with it to fortify, Reveal it to revive. Direct with it to delight. And this is why I'm charging you, and this is why Pastor said he said what he said about the Bible. Pastor Jackson, when you stand and take your stand upon the scriptures, it will turn ugly into beautiful. It will turn that which is weak and make it strong. It will take that which is poor and make it rich. It will take that which is bad and make it good. It will take that the worst and make it into the best. It will make the drunk sober. It will make the liar truthful. It will make the thief honest. It will make the pervert pure. It will make the hypocrite holy if you stand upon the word of God. It will turn burdens into blessings. It will turn cares into comfort. It will turn jobs into joy. It will turn heartaches into hallelujahs. It will turn problems into praises. It contains pardon for the guilty. It contains forgiveness to the fugitive. It contains acquittal for the accused. It contains freedom for the prisoner. It contains redemption for the ruined. The reason you need to take your stand upon the scriptures, it is the foundation of our faith. It is the rock of our redemption. It is the cornerstone of our confession. It is the basis of our belief, and it is the capstone of our conversion. Therefore, my brother, I charge you. I charge you to leave politics to the politicians. I charge you to leave legislation to the legislators. I charge you to leave protesting to the protesters. I charge you to leave rioting to the rioters. I charge you to leave policing to the police officers. I charge you to be like the Apostle Paul and know nothing else among you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I'm not charging you to be passive. I'm not charging you to be ignorant. I'm not charging you not to be concerned with your surroundings. I want to remind you that the only thing that's going to change your surroundings is the Word of God, because the Bible is still true. Paul said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. Therefore, Pastor Jackson, I charge you, every Sunday you mount this pulpit, every time you take the Sunday school floor, I charge you to tell them about a man named Jesus. I charge you to tell them that he was born in Bethlehem, and on the night he was born, heaven conducted its greatest symphony and hung the greatest star on earth around a pretentious star where a baby ages older than his own mother and the same age of his father came and bent the datelines of history around an unpretentious star. I charge you to tell them he was baptized in the Jordan River. I charge you to tell them he walked the dusty streets of Jerusalem. I charge you to tell them that he healed the sick. I charge you to tell them that he raised the dead. I charge you to tell them 5,000 hungry souls he fed. I charge you to tell them he was taken from judgment hall to judgment hall. I charge you to tell them he was whipped like a common criminal. I charge you to tell them he was nailed to an old wooden cross. I charge you to tell them that he died. I charge you to tell them that he was buried. I charge you to tell them that he rose again with all power in his hands. Pastor Ryan Freddie Jackson, I charge you to preach like Jesus died yesterday. I charge you to preach like he rose from the dead today. And I charge you to preach like he's coming back tomorrow. I charge you, my brother.
Amen. I just want to say that you ain't playing fair. Okay. Sister Ngozi, I have been given the privilege to charge you in this new endeavor of being a pastor's wife. You are about to begin a journey that is unlike anything you've probably ever experienced, and you need to know that you are an integral part of your husband's ministry. There are many preconceptions and stereotypes of what a pastor's wife is or what she's supposed to be. People tend to want to put us in a nice, neat little box built on tradition, what they saw growing up, or what they've been told a pastor's wife is supposed to be. We're supposed to wear big hats.
We're supposed to always have a smile on our face, and we can't have a bad day. Our children have to be well-behaved and always walk the straight and narrow, and they can't have a bad day either. We are always supposed to be willing to be involved in everything. Everything. I think we can all agree that pastors' wives are sometimes subjected to very unrealistic expectations, and then we're judged for not meeting those expectations. You cannot be everything to everyone. So I charge you, first and foremost, be yourself. You can do you better than anybody else. Let your light shine and allow your gifts and talents to be used to help grow the kingdom. This is your walk, so you have to make it your own. I charge you to have a strong prayer life. 1 Thessalonians 5:17 says, pray without ceasing. If you ever needed the Lord before, you definitely need him now. And your prayer life is your first line of defense. Pray for your husband, pray for yourself, pray for your family, and pray for the church and church family. There can never be too much prayer in your life. Pray, pray, and then pray some more. I charge you to say no and don't feel guilty for saying no. This little two-letter word is powerful and it's necessary. You have two small babies to raise, and your family is your first ministry. You must prioritize your time and find balance. I charge you to keep peace in your home. You have to help keep the conduit through which God speaks to the man of God open and uncluttered so the work of the ministry can go forth. While your husband is taking care of the church and all the members, you are taking care of the family and household so he doesn't have that to worry about. It allows him to focus on his ministry. We are by no means giving him a pass on helping out at home, but giving him peace on the home front is important. I charge you to be patient and understanding. There will be times you will probably feel like a single parent. Being a pastor will take your husband away from home sometimes. He will have to travel. He will have to leave the house in the middle of the night because someone is ill and or is in the hospital. Or someone has passed away and the family needs his counsel or just his presence. You are sharing him with an entire congregation. It can be a hard pill to swallow sometimes, but that patience and understanding will help that pill go down a little easier and will help you see the bigger picture. I charge you to be the best helpmeet you can be. The definition of helpmeet is a helpful companion or partner, especially one's husband or wife. Genesis 2:18 says, the Lord, after creating Adam, saw that he was alone in the garden and declared, it is not good that a man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him. I said it earlier, you are an important part of your husband's ministry. Be the help he needs so he will always be ready for ministry. I charge you to stay in your lane. Your husband will have to make many decisions based on how God is leading him. You may not understand or agree with those decisions, and you don't have to. God is speaking to Reverend Jackson, not you. So just stay in your lane and support your husband. As long as he is being obedient to God, everything will be as it should be. I charge you to embrace your new church family. Engage with them. Pray with them, pray for them, and get to know them. Build relationships and let them help you when you need it. I charge you to be ready to step out of your comfort zone. You never know when you'll be asked to do a charge at a pastor's installation. Or a deacon's installation. Or an organization or a service that is organizing a church 10 minutes before the service starts. Yeah. Be ready for the microphone to be given to you. Hopefully you'll have some warning so you can prepare, but that doesn't always happen. So just be ready. Finally, I charge you to be your husband's biggest supporter, cheerleader, listening ear, and prayer warrior. If there should ever be someone to listen, you should be the one. You have to be there even when no one else is. It is your job as helpmeet to prop him up and remind him that you always have his back. When he preaches the word and people get offended, you've got his back. If he ever gets frustrated, you have his back. You have his back in season and out of season. And together, you can face anything. God bless you.
There was a little boy, he was struggling with his history homework at breakfast time. And he was telling his dad, "I'm struggling." And his dad said, "Oh, that was hard for me when I was growing up too. Might be a little advanced your age anyway." Little boy went to class that day, and the teacher went around the room and asked a history question. And little boy didn't know the answer. And the teacher said, "Well, did you do your homework?" And he said, "Well, my pa said I didn't have to. He said it was hard for him, and it's past my age anyway." And then one of his friends looked at him, and she said, "Well, did you do your homework?" "Well, if he didn't do his homework, then I didn't get to do mine either." But one of his friends who did the homework, "Man, take one for the team, man. Take one for the team." Who didn't do their homework? All four boys stood up. The teacher just felt deflated. That day, those boys, they ran into the father's office and reported to him what they had done and said, Dad, you should have seen it. You should have seen it. We told her what you said." And the father, Andy Griffin, he said, "Now, what did I say?" Opie said, "You said I didn't have to do my homework." Now, Opie misinterpreted what his daddy meant. But still, Opie told Miss Crump, "I ain't got to do my homework." And as soon as they were telling Andy what was going on, Miss Crump stormed into the jailhouse. And she lit into Andy Taylor. And she lit into him and said, "I don't tell you how to do your job. You don't tell me how to do my job. You don't tell me what's good for these kids. I'm the teacher in this town. Let me do my job." And she stormed out of the door. And Andy is trying to figure out, how could this big old foot get in this little old mouth? And he's figuring out, okay, what can I do to turn things around? So later on, the boys came back. And he began to share with them about a gun. And he said, "Now, y'all don't want to hear a gun. It's history." "Nah, Pa, tell me." Barney said, "Yeah, tell us." And he began to tell them about Paul Revere and this gunshot that was heard around the world. And the British are coming. The British are coming. And Andy told that story. And as he told the story, he ended the story and said, "Well, it's all true." And they're captivated by the story. He said, "It's all true." And then he said, "But you got to read the book." And he got up and walked away. And they said, "What book?" He said, "Your history book. And there's more stories like that in your book." "No kidding, Pa?" "No kidding. More stories like that. Matter of fact, a couple of weeks from now, you might even come to me and start telling me stories. Why don't you form a troop, the Minutemen of Mayberry?" And, "Well, Paul, would you help us?" Barney said, "Yeah, would you help us? I mean, would you help them?" And Andy said, "Yeah, I'll deputize you once you pass the fitness test." "Well, what do you want us to do?" "Why don't you learn those history questions Miss Crump wants you to learn? Because can't everybody join your group?" And those little boys began to learn those history questions. And they began to discover what was in the book. Before, they didn't want to deal with the book until a father came in and shared with them what was really in the book. Reverend Jackson, I watched you 13 years ago. I know you knew about the book, but I began to watch your transition as you heard the Father tell you what was in the book. I watched you, brother, in prayer and Bible study, start quoting faith statements from the book. I've seen you discover your purpose because of the book. I've seen you stand flat-footed and preach with power because of the book. I've seen you and operate in conviction because of the book. So as you enter and as you continue this assignment that God has given you, I present to you, brother, this book. My father, my daddy, my brother already told you what's in the book. In this book contains your commission. In this book tells you that you're covered by God. In this book tells you that you have all the promises of God, and in them are yes and amen. In this book, we know that God has commanded you. See, the difference between a history book and this book, history book is not living. A history book is not active. A history book is not quicker than, is not sharper than a two-edged sword, piercing to the dividing of the sunder, of the soul, dividing and sharing with us what's the intents of the heart. But this book, hallelujah, not only do we study it, but this book studies us. This book, my brother, you already doing it, and I want to encourage you. Keep on preaching this book. Keep standing on this book. Keep meditating on this book. Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that's written in the book. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success, all because of the book. This is not antiquated. This is not out of style. I don't have to make this relevant. All I got to do is present what the book is. It's in the book, my brother. In the book, I got everything that I need. In the book, I know that I can walk. In the book, I got a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my pathway. In the book, I'm clean because of what's in the book, my brother. So I present to you the book. The holy word of God, the infallible, inerrant, inspired holy word of God. It's in the book. Bless you.
Amen, amen. The church has been charged. The pastor has been charged. The first lady has been charged. And presentation of the word of God. My. Amen. At this time, we're going to have moderator Connie Botzel, I believe that's how we pronounce the name, moderator of Southern Indiana Baptist District Association and pastor of St. James Baptist Church, is going to come with our installation of prayers. And we're going to ask all the pastors if you will come and stand with the moderator as the moderator prays for this new pastor. Pastor Moderator.
All the pastors in the house, will y'all please come forward? Amen. To the honorees and to Dr. Pastor Moore, my pastor, Adrian Brooks, and all the pastors. You know, I got excited of everything I witnessed tonight, and when I get excited, I talk backwards. Wow! Y'all catch that when you get home. But this is a time to talk to God. So let us pray. Father God, now we come in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Thank you for all your blessings and benefits that you've truly bestowed upon us. Lord God, we thank you for how you touched all of us early this morning to allow our golden moments to roll on just a little while longer. Thank you for your protective custody bringing these people from all across the country to support Pastor Ryan and Ngozi and his family as we install Pastor Ryan Freddie Jackson. this installation service, this installation prayer. Yes. To install means to place in position. And most of all, to connect for service.
Thank you, God.
So, Lord God, we pray now.
We pray now.
That you would place this young man.
Yes, sir.
That you would put in this position. Let him continue to preach,
yes,
pray,
yes,
and praise. Yes. Lead this congregation in the green pastures and beside the quiet waters.
Yeah.
Oh, God, we know you're able. You did it with Moses.
Yeah.
You did it with Joshua.
Yeah.
You did it with Pastor Moore. And we know you can do it with Pastor Ryan Jackson.
Yes, sir.
Lord God, we thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you now.
In the name of Jesus, continue to anoint him and lead him, oh God, as you guide him to bless this congregation and our community.
Thank you, God.
Have your way in his life, oh God. Bless, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Protect him and his family. Continue to provide for them. Preserve him. Oh God. As he proclaimed your word. Bless New Hope. As I stood here January the 20 and 21 of. Yes, they were broken. But time has passed. Well, we prayed for this day. This moment. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you.
In the name of Jesus. And all the people said amen.
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 God bless you. God bless you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, God.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, moderator Connie, for an amazing installation prayer. At this time, we'll have the presentation of the keys to the church. And then leadership remarks in that order. Deacon Jack Lowry, chairman of the deacons, trustee Kimberly Hinton, representing the trustee ministry.
See, you're going to make me laugh. Pastor Ryan Freddie Jackson. From the deacons, the trustees, members of this great historic New Hope Missionary Baptist Church, located at 663 Dr. W.R. Brown Senior Way in the city of Evansville, Indiana. We are so thankful and grateful that God sent you to us. It was his plan to send you here, because we believe that God had a plan for New Hope Missionary Baptist Church. He had a plan to take us to greater heights. And he brought you to be our shepherd to lead us down the path he wants us to go. Reverend Jackson, I've gotten to know you, and we love you. And you just got to keep doing what God has in store for you. And we're going to follow you. We're going to support you and your family because you are a godly man. You're a family man. You love your family. And you love New Hope Missionary Baptist Church. I see that already. So it's my honor and privilege to give you this key to New Hope Missionary Baptist Church. Because, and with this, you'll have unlimited access to New Hope Missionary Baptist Church. There you go, Reverend. Thank you. Appreciate it. We love you.
My, my, my. Anybody feel like shouting like I do? Pastor Moore got up with his remarks, and I just remember with one of them, I said, don't start none, won't be none. Woo! Okay, let me calm down. I've got to, yeah. I've got to do this. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place. Ooh. And I know, hey, that it's the spirit. That's all. That's all. Yeah, it is. That's not what I'm supposed to do. Did you say go ahead? Pastor said go ahead. There are sweet expressions on each face. I've got two inspirations here with me tonight, too. Sweet heavenly town. Stay right here with us. I know you will, Lord, and keep on filling us. We lift our hearts.
more cred, Pastor. Okay, 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 okay. Woo! Okay, 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 okay. Dr. Hinton worked real hard. You deserve that dance. You deserve that. Hallelujah. I'm gonna dance with you after this. I tried to get one in. Pastor even smiled at me. Ooh, glory to God. Woo! Okay, Sylvia, stop. Sylvia, stop. I see you, Ava. I see you, Ava. Okay, okay. No, 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 no. No, no, no. Let me read my little speech. And we got... No, 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 no. I wrote it, and I'm going to read it. I wrote it, and I'm going to read it. Praise God. Oh, God. That felt good. All right. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. To this prolific company of prophets, preachers, pastors, to our special guest, prophet, preacher, pastor, Reverend Addis Moore, and the Mount Zion family, to my prolific pastor, Ryan Freddy Jackson, and First Lady, my soror, in Guzzy Jackson. We're so proud to have Mama here too. Amen, amen, amen. And to my father's children who have come to share our joy, thank you so much for coming. Numbers 11, 16, 17, New International Version, says, the Lord said to Moses, bring me 70 of Israel's elders who are known to you as leaders and officials among the people. Have them come to the tent of meeting that they may stand there with you. I will come down and speak with you there, and I will take some of the power of the Spirit that is on you and put it on them. They will share the burden of the Spirit that is on you and put it on them. They will share the burden of the people with you so that you will not have to carry it alone. Pastor Jackson has encouraged us by advising us that we have to conduct business as Jesus would have done. It is the standard of Christ. This podium is worrying me. He meets with the leaders of the church. That includes the deacons and trustees, the ministers, the financial team, every Sunday morning at 8:30. And anybody who knows Kimberly Jo Hinton knows that's a challenge for me to get up so early, but I have joy in getting up to hear what the Lord has poured into Reverend Jackson so that he can pour
into us. It's a blessing. Pastor Jackson has encouraged us by advising us that we need to conduct business as Jesus would have done. It is the standard of Christ. Ephesians 4, 12 through 13. It reads, to equip the people for works of service so that the body of Christ may be built up. Verse 13 says, until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and to become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Our motto under Pastor Jackson is to engage and to re-engage. We are blessed here at New Hope to have a pastor after God's own heart, full of his anointing and a heart for the people of God. We at New Hope are excited to walk into a new thing with a new shepherd who will keep watch over the city of hope. Thank God for you, Pastor Jackson. We love you. We love you. I'm done now. We're not over. We're going to take care of y'all some more down yonder at the hotel.
She was, I found another. Can I hear me? Growing up, when I would ask Daddy for the keys to the car, to use the car, he'd give me the keys. Then later on, Reverend Chalks, I'd come back and ask him for. And he said, if I'd have known you didn't have any money, I wouldn't have told you you could use the car. I see that Pastor Jackson just got some keys. Now that he got some keys, he needs some money. So this segment is about the money that go with the keys. And so here it is. This is, and knowing what I know about preaching, about pastoring, about church, it would be totally blindsided and just ridiculous if we didn't bless this man with some money. I'm not trying to camouflage it. This is about money. And it's about positioning him, the one that we say we love, we adore. And there's a delegation from Kalamazoo came down. Kalamazoo, just stand up real quick, because we come because we love this man. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I just want you to know that he means something to us. And he means enough for us to drive down and to share in this very special occasion. And we did not come empty-handed. And so this offering is for Pastor Ryan F. Jackson. It is not for New Hope Church. New Hope, y'all get y'all Sunday morning. This is offering is for the pastor. And so if you're going to make a check out, make it out to Reverend Ryan F. Jackson. And let me give you his, cool it down just a little bit. Let me give you his Cash App, because I need you to hear that. Because if you don't have any money, we need to Cash App you. Here it is. $RFJACKSO. $RFJACKSO. And the way that Cash App works, if you get it in there, it'll show you whether it's right or not. And so now you can Cash App it. If you got check, make it out to Reverend Ryan F. Jackson. If you got cash, he'll make that out himself. So just put that in, and he'll fill that in. And so we're getting ready to give because we love him. Amen? Amen. Come on now, don't fool me. Amen. And we want to position him to do everything, because
from what I understand, from what I see, New Hope is not a cheap church. And no church, the way we've been, it's not a cheap church. And you don't want a cheap pastor. You don't want a cheap pastor. And a pastor don't want cheap members. Mount Zion is not a cheap church. Pastor Jackson is not a cheap preacher. Not a cheap pastor now. And so let's get ready to give. Let me pray. And then we're getting ready to give. Father God, now in the name of Jesus, thank you for the gift of Ryan and Guzzy Jackson. And thank you for the gift that you've given New Hope Church. Thank you for the anointing, the sacrificial love. Now, Lord, we sow into them knowing that this is good soil. And so we do it now according to your word. In the name of Jesus, amen. Now, I'm not asking, can we get some baskets? I'm going to do this a little unorthodox. Because I'm going to need pastors and preachers to come first. And I'm not asking you to follow me, but I just think it's important. The Mount Zion Church family, we brought $1,000 for Reverend Jackson. My wife and I have $500 that we want to give to the Jackson family. And so right now, and I want to do this, and I want pastors and preachers to come and join me as we give. As I say, you don't have to follow me now, but do your best. Do your best. Do your best. $1,000 from Pastor Timothy F. Timothy Troxa and the Macedonia Church.
Everybody say bless,
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 bless.
Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much. Come on, deacons. Pastor Jackson used to be a deacon. Come on, deacons. Come on. All deacons and trustees. Come on. Deacons and trustees. Come on. That's it.
I just messed all up the usher stuff. I just messed all up. It just messed it up. Now everybody else can come, and now y'all can play loud so they won't see that I messed it up. Y'all can pray loud now, and everybody else.
Everybody say
bless,
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 bless. Turn it around. It's gone on your favor. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Say
late. Late in the midnight hour.
My God.
God's gonna turn it around.
It's gonna work.
It's gonna work in your favor.
Yeah, yeah. Say late.
Lord, thank you now for every gift and every giver. In the name of Jesus, amen. Everybody good? Okay, all right. At this time, we want to hear from the Jacksons. And at first, we want to hear from First Lady Ngozi Jackson. And I'm going to ask her to come and remarks at this time.
Supposed to do it together, amen. Wow. It's different from up here looking back and seeing, oh my gosh, wow. Wow. What an amazing evening. There is so much love here in this room. There is so much love here in the city of Evansville. So all I can say is thank you. Thank you to the band. Thank you to the choir. Ryan and I were up in the front. The beat, the singing, it was beautiful. Thank you all so much for being here. Thank you to Pastor Moore. Pastor Moore, thank you so much for everything. Thank you for your leadership, for your example. He is literally the person that he is because of what you poured into him for the last 13 years of his life. So thank you so much for everything. We've heard here a lot, like, Pastor Jackson, he's always talking scripture. He says a lot of scripture. He says if it's not in scripture, we're not doing it. And that all comes through Pastor Moore. So that's where that came from. Amen. The New Hope Committee, the New Hope members, you guys showed out. This was such a fantastic day. The look at the lights, the speakers, the colors, the flowers, everything was amazing. So thank you so much for all of your hard work. It is much appreciated. Mount Zion, Kalamazoo, Michigan, Detroit, Chicago, Albion, all of the places. Evansville, you may not know that Michigan, Kalamazoo, New Hope, that is a solid 6 hours at the very least. And it was raining and it was thunderstorming and people had to take off of work. So thank you so much to all of you from Mount Zion, Kalamazoo, Michigan, all the surrounding areas to be here. We appreciate it. We know it was not an easy thing. You guys did not come down the street. We appreciate it. Thank you to everyone near and far, whether you came down the street, whether you came hours away, whether you flew, you drove, we appreciate it. I have heard today, and Guzzy, it's so good to see you, but where are the babies? But where are they? So they are at home being spoiled by the grandparents. So that's where they are. And lastly, I want to publicly thank this guy over here. This guy over here. First Lady Troxler, I feel like you said in so many, I can't see you, you said in so many words, it's okay to brag on your husband a little bit. So it's okay to brag on him. So it's okay to brag on him and do it publicly as well. You can do it publicly. So babe, he's looking good today, isn't he? Look at him, he's looking good. I saw him this morning in sweats, and I saw him today. I said, looking good, best, my husband.
But in all, it's okay to brag on your husband. In all seriousness, babe, I want to thank you so much for your obedience. I thank you for doing what God has called you to do. I thank you for practicing what you preach, not just on Sunday up here in the pulpit, but 24/7. In Mount Zion, Kalamazoo, Michigan, you guys can all agree with me that the Reverend Ryan Jackson that you all see up here on Sunday, that's the same Ryan Jackson you're going to get Monday through Saturday. So thank God for that. Thank you for being an amazing, supportive, devoted, faithful husband. And thank you for being the best dad, the best example for our two babies. I am so proud of you, and I've said this time and time again, but you make me so much better, and I love you, and we've known each other since I was, what, 19? You were 22, something like that, and it has been such a joy. It has been such a joy to see God use you. And I'm so excited to see what God is going to continue to do in this new season with us and our family here in Evansville. So I love you, and I'm proud of you. And again, thank you to all of you for sacrificing your time on a Friday night to spend with us. We really appreciate it. We love you. As you travel back to your destinations, pray for a safe travel. So thank you so much. Love you. Excited to be here. Cannot wait. Thank you.
And now, can you stand with me? The install pastor, the pastor of the New Hope Baptist Church, Evansville, Indiana, help me welcome now for the rest of the service, Pastor Ryan F. Jackson.
Giving our honor to Jesus, who is the Christ, the Son of the living God. There are moments in your life that allow you to be able to just reflect on what God has done and what he is doing. And this night is a great example of it. And I just want to thank all of you for thinking enough of my entire family to be with us this evening. So I just want to say thank you. I really do appreciate it. I thank God for my lovely wife. She has been a tremendous, tremendous support system to me. And one of the greatest things you could do for any man is believe in him. And I thank God for my wife always believing in me and wearing so many hats so well, from career woman to taking care of the kids to ambition. I am honored to do life with you. And additionally, I got another woman here that's tonight, that she looking good in her powdered blue. And it's my mother, and I praise God for her presence tonight. Where do you get your personality from, your smile from? I get it from my mama. And so I thank God for her being a tremendous support system. I also thank God for my two fathers who are not present, my dad and my stepdad, for always encouraging me, training me up in the way that I should go, so that when I'm old, I will not depart. So I praise God for them. My Mount Zion church family, traveling 6+ hours to be here with us. It means the world to me. Looking at the faces, like, for you to be able to sacrifice this weekend and sacrifice your time, I appreciate it. And Pastor Moore preaching a phenomenal word that sets the pace for my pastor. And thank you. Thank you for your training. Thank you for your tutelage. And just thank you for being you. Every week, Pastor Moore calls me, Jackson, you all right? Like, yeah, Pastor, I'm all right. He checks on his spiritual son, and so I say thank you. A night like this can't happen without a church that's behind you. A night like this can't happen without individuals giving of themselves to make this night what it is. And so I just want to highlight everyone that has worked on the installation committee. Could you just please stand? I want to highlight you. Can you help me praise God for them? They have been working for several weeks, and I thank God for the chairs. Sister Ava Demps. Sister Ava, where are you? Praise God. Help me celebrate Sister Ava for leading this effort. And also her co-chair, Dr. Hinton. Go ahead, stand up for me, please. Praise God for you. New Hope, I'm excited. I'm excited to see what God is going to do. Great church, great people. And we are getting ready to advance the kingdom of God like no other. And so thank you for allowing me to be your pastor. Thank you for your love. Every week, I got to tell you this, my members make sure I'm good. One particular week, my lips was chapped. I said, my member, don't worry about it. Next week, I came back with a full supply, lip chap, Vaseline. Pastor, we got to put some meat on your bones. So they forced me to eat 3 times a day while I'm at. They just take care of me. And I just thank God for such a wonderful church. To all of the pastors who traveled near and far, the city of Evansville in Michigan, thank you so much for your love and your support. It has been absolutely phenomenal. And to this amazing youth department here at New Hope Missionary Baptist Church, they set their pastor off right with some wonderful and amazing gifts, and I thank God for them. As we close, Pastor Moore, as we close, I'm encouraged to know that God is covering me. I'm encouraged to know God has commissioned me. I'm encouraged to know that God has charged me. And as we lead and as we navigate, we have the power of God backing us. Thank you all once again for your presence tonight. Appreciate you. Also, very quickly, are they gonna present those? They want to present those? Youth, would you like to present your gifts? All right.
Good evening again. On behalf, we are the gift committee, as a matter of fact, and on behalf of the Church of New Hope, Missionary Baptist Church, the youth department, the men's ministry, the women's ministry, the individuals that have given as well, the deacons and trustees, and Sister Chandra Taylor, and I know I'm leaving names off, but this is from the church. There are things in there for you, Miss Lady Jackson, as well as your babies. We did not forget about the babies. The youth have blessed the babies, trust me. And so we just want to express our love and appreciation to you all. And there's some goodies in there, some healthy snacks, Pastor Jackson, some Snapples up in there, all kinds of good stuff. Made me hungry. But anyway, you all enjoy what has been presented to you this evening. And again, I just appreciate everyone who participated, everyone who gave in this endeavor. The music ministry, I don't know if I mentioned the music ministry, they gave as well. Special gifts, yes, as well as the special gift committee. There's something in there from us as well. So again, enjoy. We appreciate everything you all have done and are going to do, and just be blessed.
Wow. You all know how to make a brother feel good. Thank you all so much. Thank you all so much. Let us all stand. Let us pray. God, we thank you for such a monumental night in the life of New Hope Missionary Baptist Church. God, we are excited that you are moving. God, we thank you that we have been charged. I have been charged. We have been commissioned as a ministry. God, encouraged to know that we are covered by you. God, we thank you for every person in attendance tonight. God, thank you for their love. Thank you for their sacrifice in which they made to be here tonight. Thank you, God, for what you are doing. God, I thank you so much for the Mount Zion Baptist Church and my pastor, Dr. Addis Moore. Everything, God, that he has poured out unto us, we pray, God, that you would replenish him. Thank you now, God, as we leave this place, we have your traveling grace and mercies. And God, we are excited about you, what you are doing. Now unto you who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Lord God, we love you. We honor you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Thank you all. Love you.